that's been here for a long time. There are technological, government, and corporate reservations that are highly advanced above the quasi-dormant post-industrial civilization that we live in. There is a completely engineered revolution against the natural world and natural processes being carried out by the scientific elite. And the world they are building is not a pretty one for the average person. And the world they're building is very, very cold-blooded and anti-family, anti-human, and does not look to lift up humanity, but instead to end humanity as we know it. And what's frustrating about this is not the lack of proof, but the ocean size amounts of information with the different technocrats in public communiques telegraphing their unbelievable disgust and disdain for public. They don't really publicize their disdain, but they communicate it in establishment journals, so it is public. It's open source, and it's really horrible. And then they've got all of their propaganda minions, their fake futurists and the rest of them that go out and proselytize to the low-level and mid-level manager class in academia, in the medical system, in the financial system, in the culture system. In fact, for the incredible amounts of propaganda that we see being ladled out in the so-called news, broadcast TV, cable news channels, newspapers, radio, political books. That propaganda is at least a little more sophisticated because it's targeting someone who's, quote, politically aware. Or at one level higher in complexity and understanding and one degree closer to reality. But for the unwashed masses that just think the men with suits are running things and choose a politician, even if they vote off of how they look, it's like trying to teach quantum mechanics to a boll weevil. And it's hard enough to get the general public to look around them and realize that they're in the middle of deep space on a planetoid with incredible opportunities and wonderment all around them. It's hard to get them to look up from the dirt long enough to do that. But when the system sets everything up to keep them looking down in the dirt, that's a crime against humanity, creates blowback cycles into the elite themselves, and is super bad news. So the world is being engineered into an authoritarian system, not to even shield the elite in the future, but to just totally have a revolution against our modern world itself and humanity. The news is coming up, and I'm going to break down the future of humanity straight ahead.
Did you ever think you'd be where you are? A decade into the 21st century. Record foreclosure rates for homes. If not yours, your neighbors. Thankful for the unemployment check since you were laid off. And placing your child's name on the angel tree in hopes of a Christmas gift, along with thousands of other Americans. Did you ever think your future would feel this out of control? The fact is, in all this craziness, there's only one thing you can control. Your greatest dependency, your food supply. Make 2012 the year you take control by getting prepared. eFoods Direct introduces the best way to build your food supply in the 21st century. Get a 21-day supply of food free with purchase. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Take back control in 2012. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Remember, you can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
You are listening to an InfoWars.com frontline report. If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance. From deep in the heart of FEMA Region 6, Austin, Texas, transmitting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
For more than 16 years on radio, I have pointed out that I come to you live from deep behind enemy lines, FEMA Region 6. And I remember a long time ago, different radio consultants that contacted me over the years, and you know, vice presidents and presidents at major radio networks who contacted me. It was always the same line. Okay, Alex, there is globalism. There is a move to get rid of national sovereignty, but that's a natural progression. And you need to decide whether you're going to be on a crusade that goes nowhere or whether you want to be a star. And even 14, 15, 16 years ago, when I had almost no money, it was not tempting over the years to be offered millions and millions of dollars to go join the establishment and be in the company of people that don't care about you and who have sold themselves to the highest bidder over and over again. I do not wish to sit at table or to associate with Judas Iscariot, fellow travelers of that spirit. And let's get one thing straight. It's not because I'm some goody two-shoes. It's not because I'm high and mighty. It's because I've seen reality. I've discovered reality. I've discovered the real world. And no amount of money is worth it to lie to the public and to try to deceive people with simplistic colloquialisms and pap, because doing that is basically cutting off my own nose to spite my face. It's gouging out my eyes and that of my children. I cannot and I will not join with evil. But over the years, I've had so many people contact me, station owners, sponsors, radio executives, and they say stuff like FEMA Region 6. I mean, the general public doesn't even know what that is. Well, why do you have a liner saying that? Because I want people to think about what FEMA Region 6 means. I want people to tune in at first and think, oh, it's hokey. He's talking about broadcasting from deep behind enemy lines. Because, you see, I am broadcasting from behind enemy lines. The establishment sees the United States as done, as captured, as run by the big megabanks. The big Ponzi scheme operators that have created the thousands, I said thousands, of trillions of dollars in fake financial instruments and bought our politicians for less than one millionth of it. In fact, I've had a lot of political analysts on who have pointed out that the average politician in Congress can be bought for a couple $100,000 on a major issue. And these companies can go spend a couple $100,000 per politician, per key politician, campaign chairman, and others, and then have government shut down their competition or give them a government contract worth tens of billions of dollars. And so they literally buy them for pennies, a special interest in. And you see, I've made it my life's work to discover who are those special interests and what have they set up and what is their end game and what makes them tick. And I went and read the publications and the books and the white papers and the academic communiques between these different groups, and overall they are eugenicist adherents. That is, they follow the science of eugenics. I know for new listeners, just when you think eugenics, think Hitler. But Hitler didn't invent eugenics. He was one manifestation of eugenics. And our entire world, in their own words, is a laboratory. I was at my parents' a couple hours ago. I took my children over there to visit with them and drop them off. And we were debating when I go out to Florida next month to give some speeches at some radio stations and things, whether I would take them to Disney World. And I know it's a commercial thing and exploitive and all that. I understand that. The point is, you know, do you go experience that as my parents took me to experience it? And we're having a debate about the biometrics. And my dad's saying, you know, it's just about having you opt in to finger scan and all that. They're already face scanning you. And I said, of course. But I said, the point is that I just don't want to be around it. But obviously, it's being expanded out from there. And I said, the whole thing is obviously a Department of Defense laboratory, because everything else is through DARPA. And I had my iPhone, which itself is a DARPA-projected creation. And I said, here, let's type in Department of Defense Laboratory Disney Biometrics. Because I'd already seen some of that back in the mid-90s. And I typed in Biometrics Disney, and I found the Electronic Frontier Foundation and other groups, but also found Disney press releases. How, and again, I already knew this, even though I had only small pieces of it over a decade the last time I looked at it, I already knew it was a Department of Defense laboratory. Sure enough, they're all Department of Defense laboratories. Their cruise ships are. And it says it's a Department of Defense deal. They have this new Disney USA where when you go stay at the, not just Disney World, but this other facility, when you go stay at Disney USA, it's an interactive laboratory. And when you go on the cruise ship, it face scans you, but you get to feel uppity and big that it talks to you like something out of Minority Report. And of course, they already had technology that face scans you in active billboards before that movie even came out. They had that stuff developed when Philip K. Dick was out in San Francisco writing Minority Report in the 1970s. The truth is, PKD and people like that were actually hanging around with the Silicon Valley people. Everything we've been allowed to see is at least 30 years old. That's what I'm trying to get across to you. And my dad's like, really? It's Department of Defense. And I went and typed that in. Disney, Department of Defense Laboratory. Boom. Whole thing. Human tracking testing system. But so are the grocery stores, the big ones. So are the malls. All of it. I mean, I've been given the tours of the University of Texas Psychology Department. Over 90% of it's DARPA funded. And in there, again, the first time I got a tour of it, like 15 years ago. See, it turns out Disney is testing the prison city model for the Department of Defense since their first official contract in 1996, and the guys have pulled up some documents for people watching on PrisonPlanet.tv, but you can actually just type in 1996, it'll pull it up. Because, see, Disney is a city. And so the model of tracking people going into Disney World since 96 was the model they used in Fallujah, thumb scanning, face scanning, and entering it. It's a model at the airport. But just to get you ready for prisoner training, then they put their hands on you as well. It's all dog training. And again, I've covered 1/1,000,000th of the data I've got, okay? Literally. I mean, you understand that, right? So the only way we're going to beat this technocracy is realizing it's there. And if you're a new listener like, yeah, right, the Department of Defense, Disney, go look it up. They're not hiding it. They're very proud of it. And it's the model for everything being a giant prison. To make sure you drink your sodium fluoride water, and, you know, the rest.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road.
But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it. Others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it. Others don't.
You may be arrested and or subject to other police action.
Tyranny is here. The grim future foretold in 1984 has become reality.
It really says that the state is God.
The United States is now recognized globally as one of the most oppressive police states on Earth. This film conclusively proves the existence of a secret network of FEMA camps, now being expanded nationwide. This documentary exposes how the continuity of government program has established an all-powerful shadow state. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
Did you ever think you'd be where you are a decade into the 21st century? Record foreclosure rates for homes, if not yours, your neighbors. Thankful for the unemployment check since you were laid off. And placing your child's name on the angel tree in hopes of a Christmas gift, along with thousands of other Americans. Did you ever think your future would feel this out of control? The fact is, in all this craziness, there's only one thing you can control. Your greatest dependency, your food supply. Make 2012 the year you take control by getting prepared. eFoods Direct introduces the best way to build your food supply in the 21st century. Get a 21-day supply of food free with purchase. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Take back control in 2012. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Remember, you can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
From the front lines of the information war, it's Alex Jones.
Yeah, I'm not going to spend all day on Disney World, but I did notice that Obama's going to Disney World next week, and they're going to shut most of it down for his lordship and his wife and children. But that's all part of this other fraud, this facade, this fantasy land that we see here on the cover of this week's Time magazine, Obama's World, an exclusive interview by Mr. Bilderberg Group attendee Fareed Zakaria, and it's all about how Obama actually runs things. You see, the true social engineers, the true owners of our world, want you to really believe the buck stops with a teleprompter reading lawyer who runs absolutely nothing and is a mouthpiece of the political interest and financial interest that put him in power and financed him with over $1 billion in the 2008 campaign. You notice who he just appointed as the finance head in the White House, getting rid of the old, from the famous mob family, Daley. They hired the last head of Bain Capital, who replaced Mitt Romney, the guy who supports abortion, carbon taxes, open borders, gun control, and wrote Obamacare, that Republicans are being told by the paid-for mouthpieces is the guy they've got to elect. Or they can choose Newt Gingrich, who Politico's reporting called for censorship of the internet in 2006, supports carbon taxes, world government, an end of the family. Don't believe me, just type Newt Gingrich supports an end of the family, end of sovereignty. You'll pull up his quotes. I mean, I've actually read the foreword to the Toffler's book where he said it all. Better find out. Better find out what's really going on here. But my point is that the social engineers, first and foremost, want you dependent on the system. They don't like farmers. They don't like ranchers. They don't like people that know how to skin a buck and run a trot line because a country boy can't survive. They want you in big, compact cities working for a handful of megacorporations who are authoritarian and anti-human. And the Fortune 100 themselves are financed, owned, and run by the six big megabanks globally, who on record, again, have the licensure through fraud to create unlimited currency and credit whenever they want. So imagine you've got ultra-rich fraudsters who don't go to jail like Bernie Madoff or die after sentencing like Ken Lay, who, by the way, created carbon taxes with Al Gore in 1995. Look it up. You know, those are low-level guys that end up getting burned. You know, the system sacrifices a few in this whole system occasionally to make the public think the bad guys are being punished, but it's always a mid-level nobody like Bernie Madoff. Bernie Madoff steals $50, $60 billion. The globalists steal trillions and trillions and trillions and trillions and then have the bought and paid for dinosaur sewer rat sewer line mainstream media tell you that the very megabanks that engineered the fraud that we've bailed out that are too big to fail, they're now the people in Europe, the U.S., and everywhere else that tell us what to do and that tell us what our future is going to be. And have armies of little fake futurists out there running around telling us everything's random and the world's all up for grabs. And the truth is, everything at the base level is engineered within confines, within a grid. And there is randomness within that, but that is all basically predictively scanned through Google and other systems. And I don't mean you searching Google. That's what you think the function is. When you go to Google, it's getting all the data on you, what you're into, what you read, where you go, how much money you've got, your sexual habits, what you eat, what you're thinking. When you order a pizza from a large pizza chain, it's been on record for 8 years that they run your background and sell that data to the government. And then if there's any warrants out for you, they put it in a file for the government to know. Don't believe me? Just look up USA Today on that. Scoff laws get caught ordering pizzas. The point is, you're given an iPhone. You go pay for it. You're made to line up for it. They don't manufacture enough or create the Christmas toy phenomenon of stampedes for the slave-produced product. You get it. You think that it's trendy, a totem or logo of power. It's so fun. It's the latest thing. Yeah, there's the USA Today article. Missouri tracks scoff laws via pizza delivery database. You didn't get the right to remain silent when you ordered that pizza, did you? I mean, I would tell the childlike public 15, 16 years ago that all cell phones are tracked in real time illegally by the government, but back then the public was told the NSA didn't exist. I actually had national news 14, 15 years ago repeatedly say I was insane, that the NSA didn't exist. Oh, now you all know it exists, because now they're ready to tell you. They always tell you decades after it's in place, and echelon and the rest of it. And yuppies and people that don't have a respect for themselves, they think that if they just deny something's happening, that gives them power over it. And so one day, none of this exists, but as soon as the establishment announces it exists, oh, it exists, but that's okay, because they're given a reason for it existing. Kind of like the cancer viruses they put in your vaccines. And I get emails and letters, people on the street go, well, there are too many people. Oh, really? Well, do you like dying of cancer young? You like your kid dying of it? Oh, well, no. Oh, so you were imagining you were part of the elite. But see, you aren't. See, it's very, very sick. And that's why it's very, very sick when I hear grown men and adults getting all exercised and excited about the football game or about the basketball game or about golf. And it may be, oh my gosh, did you see this? And they have all the little factoids and everything. And I'm like, why don't you get some factoids about global governance or about the post-industrial world that the technocrats are setting up, or about binary weapon systems in your food, water, and vaccines? Why don't you find out what a binary weapon system is? Why don't you just type in Rockefeller Foundation, sterilants, and vaccines? I mean, you'll be on their foundation website. They've got it all public. They think you're so stupid, it's all public. Why your 30-year-old wife can't have a kid? Or why you got prostate cancer at 40? Or why you've got all those spinal problems from the sodium fluoride? Or why your 7-year-old son just got diagnosed with bone cancer? Or why all the birth defects are so high? You know, you have that kid who's got all those organs malformed. You think you might want to know who did it. You might want to know why all this is happening. But no, you don't. Because there's this pretty, shiny, sparkly, fake glitter Las Vegas New World Order system. The fake cities of Las Vegas and Disney and the cruise ships and the biometrics and all of these little contained artificial environments. Why does the Department of Defense study those? Because they're going to turn the whole world into a Times Square where you're bombarded by the brainwashing, where you're bombarded by the propaganda, where you are a prisoner, brainwashed. Not me. I've seen reality. I've seen what the controllers see.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365. Hi, folks, this is Alex Jones, and I want to tell you about the Silver Lungs Generator. Now you can produce pure and endless colloidal silver and deliver the solution directly into the bloodstream by breathing the solution through the lungs. The respiratory system is the first line of defense for airborne pathogens and viruses. The Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced nano-silver solutions and also delivers the silver nanoparticles instantly into the bloodstream. With continued legislation threatening the sale of nano-silver products, you can now produce pure and endless colloidal silver with the Silver Lungs Generator. Very easy to follow, step-by-step instructions are provided, making production fast and simple. Go to www.silverlungs.com today and learn more about the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs Generator. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Huh.
hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
They have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today, it seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at Infowars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at SurvivalSeedBank.com. That's SurvivalSeedBank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
We are live. It is the 22nd day of January 2012. I'll have open phones and a ton of other really important news in the second hour today. I'm here every Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Blasting out on the Sunday show on more than 60 AM and FM stations. The weekday show over 100. XM channel 166. The websites are Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.com, and PrisonPlanet.tv, amongst many others, like WhatIsTheEndgame.com. Oh, you don't know what the endgame is? That's like saying, I don't know what the Matrix is. One cannot be told about the Matrix. One has to see the Matrix for themselves. And I am tending to wax philosophical here because my mind swims around the great reservoir of research I've done, and then in the spoken word to assemble the information is a great task. To try to assemble it simply. But if you assemble it simply, then that falls into the paradigm of not being three-dimensional and having depth to it. Because when you're communicating with a population that's been trained in one-dimensional thought processes, it's very, very hard. The best way to put this is the general public is basically in different degrees of sleep. And I mean technically is in sleep. You can pull up BBC articles, major studies about television being directly linked to different neurological disorders, not just seizures, but early onset of things like Alzheimer's. In fact, just type in Alzheimer's TV. First one's BBC, but there's about 3 million articles on it or hits. Last time I checked a few months ago. We'll see what it is now. Again, I want listeners to understand, every sentence I say can be pulled up as a data point. That's how my brain works. None of this is my opinion. And I know the future. Do you know why I know the future? Because the future already happened. The future is already here. We are in a subterranean, suppressed, sloth-like, slow-motion future that is dripped out like poison honey from a honey hive, and the globalists are up in their technocratic beehive, and we're down here like addled, poisoned ants stumbling around. And one cannot be told about the Matrix, one must see it. I think a simple way to put this is we are not in a matrix, but the technocrats, the globalists, are trying to build one. They're trying to build a completely artificial habitat for the general public. They're trying to limit the information you come in contact with. They're trying to make you very, very shallow. They're trying to reduce the language and the number of words people use. The system admits in so many white papers it'll make your head spin that they want to basically abolish the family. And they've done an incredible job of that. And then you read all these globalist white papers, like the Wired magazine article I've talked about for 14 years, Why the Future Doesn't Need Us, Bill Joy, co-owner Sun Microsystems. And he says in the article, you know, I went to this conference with 200 tech company owners, some of the richest guys in the world, and, you know, the debate was, do we kill everybody because they're not needed anymore, because labor isn't just cheap, it's actually a negative because of robotics and the future and claiming that humans are hurting the earth, or do we give people little mindless games and fake jobs and a fake civilization to live in? And he says, that's the debate we're having right now. And I've read similar white papers and similar articles hundreds of times from the establishment. And then I try to have a discussion with my listeners at an adult level from the perspective of what the people running this planet are really discussing. In fact, we can just type in Alzheimer's television and it'll bring up the BBC, just Alzheimer's television. And then we can also type in why the future doesn't need us. We'll show people both those. And people are listening on the radio. They go, you'll show us both? Yes, at prisonplanet.tv. We're streaming video. And there's a little free video function at Infowars.com. You want to watch it there. But you can do this. This is interactive radio. This is meant, really, this show is designed around radio. The video side of it is just a small outgrowth. Yeah, that's not the article, man jailed for sharing his father's industrial composition. Did you just type Alzheimer's television, just Alzheimer's TV, and boom, it's right there. At least it was like a month ago. Or if you type in Why the Future Doesn't Need Us, it's Wired Magazine, April issue 1999. You can pull it up right there. Did you click web or did you click news? Yeah, you don't click web because it's old. New stuff, you click news. Old stuff, you click web. There it is, BBC, top link. New stuff, you click news. Is the other way around? New stuff, you click news. Old stuff, you click web. When you're using this NSA search engine, Google. So there it is, TV's linked to Alzheimer's. Okay, here is the next one. Why the Future Doesn't Need Us, Bill Joy. It's Why the Future Doesn't Need Us. I believe it's April 1999. We'll see if I'm accurate in my memory. So, yeah, there it is. Why the Future Doesn't Need Us, Bill Joy, April 2000. Oh, see my little primitive electrochemical computer failed. You get little glitches like that. A group glitch here. hey, nobody's bad. I'm glad that you guys were going to the, I mean, how do you know that? Because radio listeners are listening and they're doing the same thing right now. And that's important. That's like last week, you know, we had an article that was linked on Drudge, this top story for like a day, that was dealing with the whole situation with the internet wars that have begun, the future of the web, the future of technological development, you know, being basically fought out right now. And from this point on, it's just going to intensify. And there's always been internet wars, but I mean, they're really, really, really kicking now. That's the Daily Bell article that came out a day after ours. Our article is, the great internet wars have begun. But that's a good article, too. I mean, I don't know. It's like I'm supposed to apologize because I'm informed. It's like I'm bad because I'm smart. I'm bad because I actually study what the global controllers are into. And they're into building a giant global prison and then killing us. And they say they're going to do it. And I'm giving you all the proof of it. And I'm still the bad guy. I mean, I would be a great guy if I got up here and I talk about the NFL playoffs. People are like, man, he's really manly. He watches something piped into his house and comments on it and lives through other people. But we're going to come back from break. And I'm going to get into the big threats to humanity. I'm going to list just a few of them for you. Then we'll start the second hour. And then I will take your phone calls and cover the other news.
Did you ever think you'd be where you are a decade into the 21st century? Record foreclosure rates for homes, if not yours, your neighbors. Thankful for the unemployment check since you were laid off. And placing your child's name on the angel tree in hopes of a Christmas gift, along with thousands of other Americans. Did you ever think your future would feel this out of control? The fact is, in all this craziness, there's only one thing you can control. Your greatest dependency, your food supply. Make 2012 the year you take control by getting prepared. eFoods Direct introduces the best way to build your food supply in the 21st century. Get a 21-day supply of food free with purchase. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Take back control in 2012. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Remember, you can bet your life on eFoods Direct. Tyranny is here. The grim future foretold in 1984 has become reality.
It really says that the state is God.
The United States is now recognized globally as one of the most oppressive police states on Earth. This film conclusively proves the existence of a secret network of FEMA camps, now being expanded nationwide. This documentary exposes how the continuity of government program has established an all-powerful shadow state. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing Diamond Gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue Diamond Gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a Diamond Gusset in the crotch. Where you need it most, Blue Diamond Gussets got it, others don't.
we turn jeans inside out. Diamond Gusset Jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond Gusset Jeans got it. Others don't.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Leading a frontal assault on the lies of the New World Order, it's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
And what is the New World Order? Well, it's the Ponzi scheme operators that were able to take over the U.S. in 1913 and many other countries before and after that date. And they issue the currency and credit. They are God on this planet through fraud, through scams, through buying off politicians. And we've lived under that hoax for so long that did you know that when you hear about your city or county or school district or state's budget, that that's a total fraud? In the 1930s and 40s, the Chicago Mafia had a 1313 system, is what it was called. And they would have a double set of books. And they would, through the city of Chicago, tell the public about the budget, but generally about 70% or more of the money was in other accounts. They just didn't call it budget. And they would have big budgetary discussions about our budget's this, our budget's that. But in the comprehensive annual financial reports, they had all the real investments and the rest of the money. And it's the same thing here. That's what I'm saying, folks. It's all completely fake. I mean, I'm sure you've heard the city of Austin's announcing between 30 and 80% rate hike increases. Overall, energy globally has gotten cheaper. But they don't care. They're saying it's for the earth. We're going to charge you more. No, it's for the big power companies that came in and used federal regulators to shut down their competition. This is happening all over the country, but here in Austin, it's more egregious because our city council is so mindless and corrupt. It's a mixture of both. And they're just going to slap these giant rate increases on people. People are like, well, that's the government trying to get a shortfall. A small part of it is a budgetary shortfall, but you're not looking at all the other accounts that are off the budgetary discussion that no one ever talks about. I mean, folks, if you're a new listener, this is big medicine I'm giving you. This is the man behind the curtain. This is the lottery numbers. This is the big kahuna. And I hope it's not pearls before swine. And it just goes on from there. I remember in 2000, the federal government only had a few dozen Predator drones. And they were saying by 2012, more than half of the Air Force's force would be drone. And I saw a number just 2 days ago of they've now got 7,000 Predators alone. And they've got all these Reapers and all the rest of it. And then there's that whole discussion there of humans aren't even going to be involved in the military soon, except for servicing the equipment. And so that makes you more detached from war crimes. And now they've announced with the NDAA, they'll secretly arrest citizens and bomb any country they want without even talking to Congress. And The police are using predators and reapers on citizens now for stolen cows or pot grows or whatever the case is. America, it doesn't even exist anymore. The United States was beachheaded in 1913 with the Federal Reserve and has been taken over by the military-industrial complex. It's self-controlled by the technocratic elite. That's the rest of Eisenhower's 1961 speech. It's just totally fake. It's totally fake. And how do you talk to a public that doesn't know even the three branches of government, much less that that's been usurped, and that the entire military is going to combat drones in the air, combat robots on the ground, that the globalists have all these white papers saying soon they'll be able to do whatever they want because they're going to have big enough robot armies to not rely on U.S. troops not pulling triggers on citizens. There's a giant national security state being built behind a tissue-thin curtain, and now they've pulled that down, and it's staring us right in the face. I mean, how many years did I tell you that they were going to be using military and police on the streets of America? How many years did I tell you before 9/11 there'd be giant terror attacks? And I said they'd probably blow up the World Trade Center, by the way, that's on record. Even Rolling Stone, New York Magazine, Nightline, they've all reported on that. That is a fact. They didn't believe it. They went and checked. I said, they'll blow up the World Trade Center, blame it on their asset bin Laden as a pretext to invade this list of countries, which were accurate, and as a pretext to set up domestic security checkpoints that'll begin in the airports. I even said they'd launch a bio attack shortly after the attack on the World Trade Center. And thanks to the ADL, it's not just me saying that, it's on record. The ADL, on September 12th, in an article titled, What They're Saying, attacked me and said, Jones says a bio attack has already been launched. Why didn't the FBI come and question me? I mean, how did I know the World Trade Center was going to be blown up? How did I know a bio attack had already been launched? You ever think about that? Do you realize what I've done in front of all of you? Do you realize that I've completely reverse engineered their entire system to the point that I'm at my parents' house today and I say, Disney World is a Department of Defense laboratory. Never even seeing that information. I knew they were involved in developing biometrics, and we pulled it up with Department of Defense white papers, and we've put them on screen here today. How did I know that? Because the whole thing's a laboratory. President Eisenhower warned you. I'm not psychic. The whole thing's fake. The whole thing at the top. Mid-level and low-level, it's not. They're not in complete control. The matrix is not complete. We're not out of the game. At the top, it's all standardized, and the system is trying to get us to basically enter into their totally artificial environment. That's why all over the U.S., England, and Canada, they're fining people in major cities for backyard gardens. If you're a new listener, just type it into the search engine. I'm not kidding. But guys, type in SWAT team for growing cucumbers. You'll get Canada. You'll also get the U.S. Because they say in Tulsa, Oklahoma, you can't be trusted growing a garden in your backyard. It might be drugs. Even Forbes a few months ago said, why are there thousands of raids on lemonade stands? Why is the federal government obsessed with lemonade stands and giving grants to local police to go after them? Because your kids have got to be trained. Everything you do is in a big box store. Everything you do is in a I mean, you walk into these box stores, Disney World, cruise ships, airports, it's cameras hanging every 5 feet, it's data mining, it's customer cards, tracking everything you do, it's total control. And I remember 15 years ago reading about all the major Safeways, you name it, had hidden retina scanners that were tracking the eye as you look at products. Now it's admitted that it's in most big stores. I was even taken by one of the head people, off record, obviously, I wasn't allowed to talk about it, they said, for 1 year because they were going to another university. Into a Department of Defense laboratory. You're like, where is that? University of Texas facility. That psychology department is only a small public building, public front for underground bases, monkey farms, weaponized, you name it. Stuff that'll kill 9 out of 10 people on your block. Every department is about brainwashing and how to manipulate men and women and what pheromone to add and what chemical to put in the water. I mean, it was incredible. And I was only shown a small part of it. Not even the classified stuff. I was only showed restricted. The person would show me, he said, well, as you know, top scientist, I'm allowed to show you restricted stuff because it's not classified. But I mean, I'm not saying they flipped on the classified video feed to those giant labyrinths and those monkeys jacked in looking at those TV screens, testing weaponized flicker rates to brain damage you and your family and put you into a mesmerized state. I mean, holy mackerel. Do you understand? You are targeted. You're being attacked. You're being bombarded chemically, biologically, radiologically, light waves, color, pheromones, olfactory, everything. And I'm talking to FBI agents, police, military, bureaucrats, all of you that think you're part of the power elite and the structure. You are the enemies of the New World Order, just as I am. This is a tiny elite. There are no more than a few thousand global master technocrats that even understand the information you're being given here, ladies and gentlemen. And if you're doubting me, folks, I told you about NDAA years ago. I told you about TSA highway checkpoints a decade before it happened. How much have I told you? I am one of the only people who understands the full spectrum system who doesn't work for the enemy. Do you understand that? Second hour coming up. Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, that we're pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
I have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at Infowars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
I was just thinking during the break, if you were going to practice shutting down cities, lining people up, arresting certain individuals, surveilling and tracking the every move of all the others, where would you test that? You'd test that at Disney World. And that's how my brain just clicks. I'm like, Department of Defense Laboratory. Because I know their nomenclature. Boom, look it up, Department of Defense Laboratory. And again, it's not that I'm that smart. Somebody who's been watching football for 20 years, obsessed with it, you're going to know, you know, as much as the guys on ESPN or more. It's the same thing here. I've actually studied what's really being built, what's really going on around me. And I understand why the average person just goes, oh, that can't be true. Because you're taught you can choose your reality. You're taught that you can just say, oh, I don't believe this guy. But that doesn't change the facts. We might as well have little gray-headed aliens with big black eyes, like science fiction says, running things. Because the globalists are that removed from humanity. They're that cold-blooded. They're that hateful towards their own species. And in their own publications claim they're another species and transcendent. And they're going to get their world government. We're not going to be part of the future. And the globalists will get the life extension and only the elites will get the digital augmentations. The pace of change that we are about to see as a society is mind-boggling because we've been in a frozen stasis culturally with just slow little incremental changes, just coloration changes, presentation changes in 30-year-old tech that the globalists developed and bought and stole and put together. And now they've decided to go ahead and start accelerating a lot of the programs and the change. And if they are successful, 99.9%+ of those that help usher it in will be destroyed, will be crippled, will be made destitute, if they're lucky, by it. But because they are living in a fantasy land, because they're receiving false data, they won't even know that on the journey. They'll think they're winning, and they'll think it's a tragic event when they fail, and then it's somebody else's fault. It's all scripting. When you believe anything a liar says, you'll believe anything. You see, sometimes I can't just get up here and cover the news and analyze it. Because even within covering this news, we play into the paradigm of the social engineers. The way to defeat the New World Order is to really awaken to the fact that this civilization, to a great extent, has been pre-planned. And I said to a great extent because they're not in complete control. They're trying to get in complete control. You know, that's the most important point. I haven't made it. If the globalists get their system in place, what would the complete control look like? Look in my eyes. You've got a lot of ancestors and all of their experiences. You've got intuition. You know the truth. I've seen the future, and so have you. We've got to change it.
Did you ever think you'd be where you are a decade into the 21st century? Record foreclosure rates for homes, if not yours, your neighbors. Thankful for the unemployment check since you were laid off. And placing your child's name on the angel tree in hopes of a Christmas gift, along with thousands of other Americans. Did you ever think your future would feel this out of control? The fact is, in all this craziness, There's only one thing you can control. Your greatest dependency, your food supply. Make 2012 the year you take control by getting prepared. eFoods Direct introduces the best way to build your food supply in the 21st century. Get a 21-day supply of food free with purchase. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Take back control in 2012. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Remember, you can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
We now take you live
to the Central Texas Command Center
in the heart of the resistance. You're listening to the Alex Jones Show.
I'll tell you what, I've spent an hour, 45 minutes, minus the commercials, kind of segueing in and out of the heart of my concerns dealing with the technocratic elite that are pre-designing our future and our technological development. It's very painful to hear talk show hosts talking about Steve Jobs and all of his innovations when that is multi-decade old technology and was rolled out according to a predestined, pre-established plan. The North American Union, the Asian Union, the Euro, all of it developed, set up by 1957 with the Treaty of Rome. A contemporary example that I use commonly is the Pentagon still claims the SR-71 Blackbird, developed in 1952 and serviced by 1955, is the fastest aircraft to this day in 2012. Or a more modern example is the B-2 bomber, stealth bomber. Test models were developed and already deployed in the 1960s. It was in service by the 1970s and, of course, was not revealed to the public until 1987, or was it 88? Guys, look up, just do a memory test here. My primitive electrochemical system, interface it with a silicon version, and let's pull up the B-2 bomber public rollout. I believe it was 87 or 88. Perhaps it was 89 now that I think about it. Let's just find out. Okay, continuing here. The reason I'm so concerned, let me just give you one small data point of literally hundreds on the subject of mass death, mass population reduction. Because this is something that I've been talking about for a very, very long time with great concern, because I've been able, in deep research, investigate why Western governments are building gigantic, quasi-secret, doomsday scenario facilities all over the world. Why are they building animal and human DNA arks in remote areas of the Himalayas, the Arctic, the Antarctic, the frozen tundra? B-2 rollout was 88. Thank you. I watched the continuity of government system via NATO and the United States, but the Russians and Chinese are also been obsessed with it, spending in some years upwards of 10% of the entire defense security budgets on building giant underground bases, with nuclear power, underground reservoirs. You know, people could live under there for 100 years. I watched this, and I watched, since I became really awake 18 years ago, quasi-awake 18 years ago, I became fully awake 15. I watched And just because you're awake doesn't mean you know everything. It means you're now awake. You're able to learn. I watched this mad rush like the end of the world was coming. And then I learned, because these people leak stuff and they talk and the different academics talk, that they're not concerned about a meteorite. They're not concerned about little green men. They're not concerned about even nuclear war so much as they are biological weapons. And again, if you're driving along in your car right now, let's say you got your family in the car, maybe there's six of you in the vehicle. Statistically, if any of these weapons are released, and I'm going to talk about it here in a moment, statistically, if any of these are released, everyone in the car will be dead. Now, I know that's not as important as NFL playoffs. But see, there won't be any NFL playoffs if this happens. And I have then discovered in the last 5, 6, 7 years, my research just confirmed in triplicate, in spades, every angle I look at it, that they're not building these bunkers because they're worried about some rogue group producing and releasing airborne Ebola with a 94% kill rate, or human mouse pox with a 99% airborne kill rate, or different variants of bird flu and others with a 91, 92% kill rate. That's 9 out of 10 on your block dead. End of civilization as we know it. They're not doing this because they're worried. The only thing I have to figure out is if they're going to go ahead and release it, as they're clearly building up towards, why they're running around, I guess for some future history. Maybe that's it, so they can blame it on out-of-control biological testing so that once they reemerge and set up a new civilization, they'll have an excuse for a total police state tyranny over all biological and nanotech developments. Because the entire establishment acts like we don't even exist and they don't even care if we're wise to them and they're just getting ready for the end of the world, while setting up 36 level 4 bioweapons labs in level 2 and 3 containment and setting up over 200 other facilities that are barely level 2 that have level 4 weaponized airborne total death being developed in them. Because, you know, the globalists sell to kind of mid-level minions and establishment types who think world government's like some Star Trek thing, because like baby ducks, they were imprinted with that. That, oh, it's just a big, you know, we all run around in jumpsuits and fly around in jetpacks in the global government and have, you know, hot blonde girlfriends or whatever. You know, that's in all the different movies and stuff. No, you're dead in that future. You don't exist. They send automated robot crawlers in to pull you out of the underground parking garages and your basements. You're not flying around wearing tinfoil outfits in the system, okay? Looking at it, the only answer there is they're just passing out all these bioweapons like dum-dum suckers at the barber. They're handing them out to any government, putting the full ingredients, the full breakdown, how to make all this stuff on the internet, because I guess in their weird, sick way, they're just going to let someone else produce it or leak it or have a mistake or claim a terrorist got it. And I've seen that in other models. 2000, foot and mouth, weaponized, England. I could tell it was a government operation. How? I'll give you a data point in a moment. Several data points. But I knew that that was weaponized because in a two-day period, it popped up from Scotland to southern England at hundreds of ranches, hundreds of farms. You don't have a foot and mouth pop up and show up all over the place at once unless it was governmental or major corporate launched. And sure enough, about a year after it happened, and they killed 8 million sheep, 4 million cows, used it to take over, have government control, try to break the farms in the UK. It came out, and the government and the BBC and other publications said, we believe an animal rights activist who doesn't believe in domesticated animals at this particular zoological level 4 bioweapons facility must have stolen it. But that's impossible. One man, one woman, or even a group of a few dozen terrorists couldn't get that all over the UK and have it all pop up on a two-day period with a government announcement PR on top of it. That's another data point, the slickness of the announcement. But the issue here is that they're probably going to let a low-level group release some airborne system that kills the majority of those that come in contact with it as the excuse to have the bio clamp down police state so they can then release something even more deadly later. And I think I've just answered my question right there. But they're passing it all out.
Hi, Jones, I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds could become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions, yet many are unaware of the entire function of the Silver Lungs system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs generator. Not only does the Silver Lung system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lung system at www.silverlungs.com. to learn more about how the Silver Lung system works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Did you ever think you'd be where you are a decade into the 21st century? Record foreclosure rates for homes, if not yours, your neighbors. Thankful for the unemployment check since you were laid off. And placing your child's name on the angel tree in hopes of a Christmas gift, along with thousands of other Americans. Did you ever think your future would feel this out of control? The fact is, in all this craziness, there's only one thing you can control. Your greatest dependency, your food supply. Make 2012 the year you take control by getting prepared. eFoods Direct introduces the best way to build your food supply in the 21st century. Get a 21-day supply of food free with purchase. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Take back control in 2012. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Remember, you can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Hey,
Look, here's the point I'm trying to get at, and then I'll go to the news and take your phone calls coming up. We'll give the number out. We, as a society, have obviously let technology grow at a pace that way outstrips our ability to even understand it as individuals. And the central controllers of our society are idiot savants. They know how to basically juggle the data to a certain extent, and by controlling the overall capital feeds, they can buy up and steer development in a direction they want. But in all the globalist publications, and you can pull these up, all they talk about is establishing a world government and then forcibly reducing our population by at least 80%. And those aren't idle threats by Ted Turner or Dr. Eric Pianka at University of Texas Biology Department or Peter Singer at Princeton or Prince Philip or Prince Charles or the Club of Rome or the UN Biological Diversity Assessment in 1996 or Maurice Strong. And anybody who's gone to college knows you've been fed this line about humans being a parasite and we got to reduce the numbers. This is the religion of those that run the globe. My point is they really intend to try to carry it out. All of the jacking poison in the water and cancer viruses in the vaccines and bisphenol A to reduce your fertility, estrogen mimickers, all of that is just macabre beta testing in this thing. I mean, where people are poor and don't have media and can't stand up for themselves, in Africa, Latin America, and Asia, I mean, every day I see articles. We could pull them up. You know, 15 babies die in illegal vaccine test. 31 of 50 homeless in Poland given shot die. CBS News, government polio vaccine program causing polio. And I just look at it. And if you're a new listener and you were joining us during the last segment, and I'm talking about weaponized super viruses. I mean, here's the Boston Globe today. And I really should be more positive because at least this stuff's being somewhat discussed now. Scientists pause research with lab-bred bird flu. It's a super contagious, airborne, highly lethal bird flu. AP reports, again, posted in the Boston Globe. Scientists who created easier to spread versions of the deadly bird flu said yesterday that they are temporarily halting more research as international specialists debate what should happen next. Now, the FBI, as you know, a month ago told them do not publish, as you did with mousepox and airborne Ebola and the rest of it, do not publish how you made it. Because in the case of mousepox that kills 99% of whatever mammal you tailor it for, that was published. A couple $100,000, and you've got the right biochemist, you can make it. And it's public. You think the FBI spies on the internet because they're scared of somebody with the anarchist cookbook? Only thing they'll do with that is blow your hand off. We can survive provocateurs, idiots, numbskulls, you know, bombing a bank or something and killing three people. It's a tragedy, but it won't kill billions. And you see, some of the higher-level academics will say, well, Alex, they're setting up a global technocracy to stop the release of this stuff. No, it's the technocrats that are making sure that they have weaponized viruses, hundreds of them, in level two facilities where you wear gloves and a mask and swipe a card and a door opens. You're supposed to have level four bioweapons in underground bases, three levels down, with three fences with minefields and machine gun nest. I mean, that's federal law. You ever seen the Andromeda strain? That's of course, a great medical doctor and writer who put that together. It's fiction, but it's based on real level four facilities. That's a level four facility. In fact, in the old days when they were messing with stuff like this, they reportedly had hydrogen bombs buried under them. Because let me explain something. If this stuff gets out, almost everyone listening to my voice is dead. And I want to know why the people running the world today are putting level four human and zoological diseases in level two facilities like the University of Texas at Galveston. When they first built it 8 years ago, I said it could be hit by a hurricane. Did you know it was hit by a hurricane and pretty much destroyed? They claim that they got the viruses out before it hit. Again, I know this is a lot more important than the NFL playoffs. That's why I'm here. And I see a global elite running around 24/7 with private bunkers and government bunkers and big corporate bunkers and talking about how great it's going to be, the age after humans, and how the world's going to come back, and the futurists say there'll only be a few hundred thousand elitist, and then it'll be this wonderful age where they repopulate the world and build it however they want. And they're just like somebody hyping themselves up to jump off a cliff 300 feet into water. They're just getting themselves hyped up to release it. And then creating a weird pre-nostalgia with all these TV shows and stuff about all humans are about to die. And fake self-fulfilling 2012 prophecy garbage. And they got the churches saying, praise God, it's the end of the world and all this stuff. It doesn't have to be the end of the world if we wake up to what's happening. Because they're not up to the point of their entire military being robot and drone. The globalists cannot carry this out yet by themselves. They're going to need people that work for the system to carry this out. They're not in complete control. I'm on well over 100 radio stations. Just on video streaming sites a week, it's over 5 million people now watching and listening to the show a week, just on video streams on YouTube and some other platforms. I mean, we're challenging the globalists. We weren't in their equation because there's not very many of them. Maybe a few thousand that have most of the puzzle, a few hundred that know it all. And I know why it's so hard for people to understand this, because it's so diabolical. I'm going to give the number out. Last week I took pretty much calls for 2 hours. Today we're just taking them in the last few segments. And I haven't even gotten to the news yet, because all the other news is secondary to this. Toll-free number to join us, 877-789-ALEX, 877-789-2539. I hope you'll call in on the subject I've raised, the future of humanity and the main threats we face. All right, the big news straight ahead.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. Put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gusset's got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans, made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't.
Tyranny is here. The grim future foretold in 1984 has become reality.
It really says that the state is God.
The United States is now recognized globally as one of the most oppressive police states on Earth. This film conclusively proves the existence of a secret network of FEMA camps, now being expanded nationwide.
This documentary exposes how the continuity of government program has established an all-powerful shadow state. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Did you ever think you'd be where you are a decade into the 21st century? Record foreclosure rates for homes, if not yours, your neighbors. Thankful for the unemployment check since you were laid off. And placing your child's name on the angel tree in hopes of a Christmas gift, along with thousands of other Americans. Did you ever think your future would feel this out of control? The fact is, in all this craziness, there's only one thing you can control. Your greatest dependency, your food supply. Make 2012 the year you take control by getting prepared. eFoods Direct introduces the best way to build your food supply in the 21st century. Get a 21-day supply of food free with purchase. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Take back control in 2012. Call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. Remember, you can bet your life on eFoods Direct.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Okay, Nate, Bobby, Jason, many others. We're going to get to your calls after I go over some of the news now. But here's the Associated Press scientists pause research on basically weaponized lab-bred bird flu. Fears raised over lab-bred airborne strains. But notice the main concern is here out of CBS News in Dallas. Dallas plant investigated for dumping pig blood into Trinity River. And they think that some pig blood out of a slaughterhouse might have run out and dripped in a creek and gotten into the river. Oh my gosh, we're all in so much trouble. And I'm not saying that that isn't important, but compared to airborne weapons that under government contracts, these universities and others are producing, where are the priorities? You know, who's concerned about GMO from Monsanto and others infecting every soybean, every corn, every wheat, every maize variety, as they are? And then in all the big studies, organ failure in the rats that eat it. And so it goes and infects all the other seed lines. And that's not a problem, but a couple, you know, some blood might have gotten a river, though. You know, we're all really scared right now, that pig blood. That's the type of issue that we're talking about here. While we're worried about something like that, the big mega corporations who've basically written the laws and the regulations and their people are over all the regulatory agencies, they're not even getting looked at. Talking about arrogance, you know that cruise line disaster? I got a story here out of the London Telegraph. Costa Concordia, insulting cruise offered to survivors. They've offered them a 30% off on their next cruise. Oh, that's funny. That is really, really funny. Isn't that owned by Carnival Cruise Lines? Yeah, I saw that in the news. Costa Concordia, but it's like a sub-corporation. You know, that captain's learned from Baghdad Bob and our own criminal government's baloney propaganda spin machine. When the Italian Coast Guard ordered him to get back onto the ship and help people get off, it turned out he ordered dinner on the lifeboat, though. He was having a drink. He said, oh, I fell into the lifeboat on accident, but I'm not going back. And see, if you question an authority figure, that's called conspiracy theory. We've all been taught that virtue to never question government or big corporations. In fact, they should have just said the whole wreck was a conspiracy theory. Just the ships there sinking on the coast of Italy, just say it didn't happen. And if people show video, just say it's not there. Kind of like I can prove that Al-Qaeda works for the criminals that run our government, that all the major terrorists have been led into the U.S. and are protected from the underwire bomber on Christmas Day to Amiral Alaki hanging out at the Pentagon. But none of that matters. It's a conspiracy theory. So just say the ship never capsized, never listed, and isn't there. Just say Italy doesn't exist. Because after all, remember Karl Rove's quote about how he controls reality? And you've got a public that sees it as a virtue to get conned, a virtue to get hurt, a virtue to follow all this pablum. Hey, look at this one out of Politico. Federal prosecutor to take the Fifth Amendment and Fast and Furious probe. Oh, it's the prosecutors, the guys that get the bad guys, the guys that get 98% conviction rate. Do you really think 98% of people are guilty? No, the for at least 20 years. Almost all the federal grand juries are criminals who would send a one-year-old to the gas chamber if told to. I mean, they will convict anyone they're told to. Okay? Because who runs these grand juries? They're not supposed to, but it's the prosecutors. And, of course, it was all in federal filings a year plus ago. That's why they came up with a cover story of, oh, we just had some guns at some gun shops in Texas and in Arizona and Illinois and some other states. We just had some guns that we were letting be sold to track them down to Mexican drug gangs. Of course, the federal documents from the beginning in federal court that the government declared national security on was that our criminal government, you know, the thing run by the Ponzi scheme banks that, don't worry, you're going to destroy everything. And don't worry, yuppies, you like to get hurt, you're going to get hurt. So just giggle at the radio, have fun, don't worry, you'll get everything you want. It's all real funny to laugh at people that are informed. They said it was to blame the Second Amendment. And of course, I told you that over a year ago, but CBS News 2 months ago reported that, oh, sure enough, the federal documents have now come out in subpoena, that it was all meant to blame the Second Amendment. Of course, that was domestically. Internationally, it was to ship guns into Mexico, but also Texas, Chicago, Indiana, Florida, to give it to drug gangs that were shooting and killing the other drug gangs that weren't laundering their money through big U.S. banks, which means globalist banks. Remember Wachovia, Wells Fargo, $376 billion last year they reported on? In a two-year period? Oh, but don't worry, they paid a $110 million fine. Well, we did the math on that once. It's like something like 0.03% or something. So, I mean, why shouldn't they go for broke? Why shouldn't they do something new? Why shouldn't they? You know, and again, they say that in the land of crazy people, the sane person is the nut. Or they say in the land of the blind, the one-eyed man is king. Maybe I am the crazy one. Maybe I am the bad one. Because, see, when the whole government's corrupt at the top, and you got a bunch of naive sheep below them that enjoy being hurt and think it's cute and, you know, winning to repeat what they're told, talk show hosts and others, that if Here's an example. If you wanted to arrest a communist or a Jew or a Seventh-day Adventist or whatever the case was in 1932 Germany for no reason and kill them, that would be a felony and you go to prison in Germany. But see, Hitler took over and was a tyrant and said it was legal. Of course, you can't really legalize tyranny in common sense, but if people go along with it, in a way you can. And so he could kill tens of millions of people total. And 22 million Germans died in the war. Civilian and military, they really got blessed. 60 million of them, 22 million went bye-bye. Oh, that went well. Going along, they were trendy yuppies too then. They did what the radio and newsreels and newspapers said. Because, you know, the terrorists blew up the Capitol and other stuff. Of course, it was really the Nazis. But, hey, it was fun to get mad. Fun to get worried about terrorists. You know, some Polish terrorist, oh, you know, they're all bad. Oh, Muslim, they're all bad. You know, it was fun. It was fun to have one-third of the Germans go bye-bye. Yeah, one-third of the Germans just, oh, 22 million at the end of the war, bye-bye, in Germany alone. Oh, that went well. That went well. But I forgot how I got on the subject of Germany. Oh, yeah. When your government's run by absolute criminals who compete with each other, so the very worst get in to the power structure, it's just legal for them to ship guns into Mexico and then blame it on the Second Amendment. And even when they got caught, I said last year, watch, they'll still use it. And you know what? They couldn't get Congress to pass a law restricting gun sales in the U.S. So they just, the ATF just sent letters threatening to arrest gun dealers if they sold the rifles and didn't jump through these new hoops. And of course, the rifles were already all registered to the instant check, but they didn't care. It was about the ATF saying, you'll do what we say outside of law. Kind of like the federal government shutting down power plants all over the country outside of law. Congress didn't pass a law, but they're doing it. Obama is launching wars without Congress, but Congress itself signed a law saying, I can be arrested, you can be arrested and disappear forever, be tortured, be killed. It's called the NDAA. And don't worry, they will use it and they will abuse it. All right, I haven't even gotten into a bunch of other news here, but we're going to come back, go to your call. Stay with us.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup, insurance, and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365. Hi, folks, this is Alex Jones, and I want to tell you about the Silver Lungs Generator. Now you can produce pure and endless colloidal silver and deliver the solution directly into the bloodstream by breathing the solution through the lungs. The respiratory system is the first line of defense for airborne pathogens and viruses. The Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced nano-silver solutions and also delivers the silver nanoparticles instantly into the bloodstream. With continued legislation threatening the sale of nano-silver products, you can now produce pure and endless colloidal silver with the Silver Lungs Generator. Very easy to follow, step-by-step instructions are provided, making production fast and simple. Go to www.silverlungs.com today and learn more about the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs Generator. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
I have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at Infowars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that it could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at SurvivalSeedBank.com. That's SurvivalSeedBank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Defending the Republic from enemies, foreign and domestic. It's Alex Jones.
All right, I got about 20 phone calls here. I'm going to give each person about a minute. We'll get about 10 or 11 of them in during this segment. I meant to get into the Great Internet Wars Have Begun, an article by Kurt Nemo and myself. I'll cover it more tomorrow on the weekday show because it isn't just about the internet and freedom of the web that's under attack. It's the entire technological infrastructure that's having back doors and Trojan horses built into it. We're going to document that tomorrow, 11 a.m. Central, 12 noon Eastern. If you don't have a local AM or FM in your area, Infowars.com is the website. Nate in California, you're on the air.
Hey, Alex, how you doing, buddy?
Good.
Yeah, so, yeah, I'd like to talk about maybe the TV. I think that's a big problem, obviously. They sold it to us back when they first invented it. As, you know, they'd have all wholesome shows on, and it was good. We could trust it. And then now, if you look at it, it's obviously promoting 180 degree different. And I think that is where a huge problem.
But it's more than that. It puts people into a mesmerized near sleep state. It's a quasi waking, sleeping dream state, similar to hypnotism.
Yeah, for sure.
You realize the brainwaves overall, the average person is in a lower brainwave state than they were before television was invented. I mean, people are actually in a trance. That's why they won't listen to you.
Yep, and it's sad. One thing about Ron Paul, if I could, I believe he's the only one that is electable because, yeah, if Newt Gingrich or Romney gets in, he's only going to get the far extreme right. I mean, we need somebody like Ron Paul that's going to get a Democrat and an independent and a Republican. So,
well, you're right. You're right, Nate. The polls show that Ron Paul does better than any other Republican candidate head-to-head. Gallup and others show this against Obama. More than that, he's the only real candidate that isn't bought and paid for by the globalist.
Right, yeah, no, I see that 100%. But I'm just trying, I try to tell that to Newt Gingrich supporters, you know, and all that kind of thing. But
sure, I hear you. I'm going to jump. Good points. The average talk show host just repeats the talking point that Ron Paul can't win as a self-fulfilling prophecy and thinks that they're a winner because they go along with the propaganda that he can't win. And then when he doesn't win, they're satisfied and feel like they're winners. And that's a self-fulfilling prophecy of fraud. And Ron Paul's really freaked him out being in second place in most polls, the fact that he's basically bucked all that. But it's a manifestation of the awakening. Great points, Nate. Robbie in New York, you're on the air.
Hey, how you doing, Alex?
Good.
Newt Gingrich just kind of came out of nowhere last night, didn't he? with the primary there.
Yeah, we've got an article at Infowars.com concerning what looks like fraud. We know Iowa was fraud. That's in their local papers now, that the Iowa thing is completely in the air. And Karl Rove says they're going to have a gentleman's agreement on who gets the delegates. So.
Yeah, and it's funny, they put Paul down in fourth as if somehow Santorum, Romney, and Gingrich all managed to beat him. I don't believe that for one second, you know.
Well, we've had top elections experts on, and they say South Carolina is just fraud central.
Yep. But one more thing, it looks like Issa, you know how he's a former ATF head. He's kind of acting like he's trying to act like he's actually trying to get some answers, but at the same time, you know, he's trying to protect, you know, the past administration and whatnot. So he's putting up a show that he's actually trying to prosecute these guys, and at the same time, he's not really doing anything about it, you know? I mean, I don't know.
Look. I said months before it was announced that Issa was going to have to basically stop his investigation because Fast and Furious, under other names, was going on under Bush, under Clinton. Iran-Contra wasn't the first time our government shipped guns out and drugs in. They shipped the guns out to the gangs to control the supply. It's $500 billion a year. The big banks launder it. The government brings it in. And the only people they shut down are the small cartels that don't launder their money through them. They made drugs illegal. Our government made drugs illegal in the 30s because alcohol prohibition had ended, and the corrupt government had made so much money off alcohol prohibition, they wanted something new. And again, by having it illegal, it jacks the prices up, A, but more importantly, B, it allows them to send the police after their competition. Great points. I appreciate your call. And, of course, he's getting the point of federal prosecutors taking the Fifth Amendment in Fast and Furious probe. And nothing's going to happen to them, folks. They did what they were told. I mean, the U.S. government doesn't just run drugs. They run kidnapped kids. And if you don't know about that, just type it in. I mean, there's congressional hearings. And I've watched congressional C-SPAN where Congress people say, well, this company kidnaps little kids. And they go, yes, they do. And they're allowed to. And they go, no one gets in trouble. And they go, nope. I mean, it's you can type that in. Rumsfeld questioned on child sex trafficking. Type that into YouTube. And he goes, nope, they don't get in trouble. And the Congress people go, so nothing's going to happen. He goes, nope. And they go, okay. I mean, they're going to bring the drugs in. They're going to put cancer viruses in your shots. They're going to do whatever they want. I mean, have you not figured this out yet? They do what they want because you're naive. People say, well, then why are you still alive? Because if they kill me, it highlights everything I've said. It puts an exclamation point behind it. And they still might. And quite frankly, I don't want to die, but I don't care. I'll never commit suicide, I'll tell you that. But I mean, you know, somebody's going to stand up to this scum. And let me explain why they're so evil. Once the system gets criminal across the board, one group of criminals can't tell the other group, hey, you're going too far, because the other group will say, hey, you're involved in crime. I'll rat you out if you go public. So once you get a systemically corrupt society, the sky's the limit. They can't tell DU weapons lobbyists, hey, this wasn't used until 1990. It kills all our troops that use it. May take 20 years, but it kills them. You can't use that. They go, hey, you're running drugs and kidnapping kids. Shut up. Yeah, but we're going to have to pay for insurance claims on all these troops. Don't worry. We'll have a Department of Justice agreement letter, 1998, that you don't have to give any of the dead troops any of their death benefits. That's AP Bloomberg. I mean, so the whole thing starts crumbling where the criminals just go, party time! And they go wild. And that's now happened. And I look at the naive public. I mean, they're helpless. I'm in stores and places, and I look at these fathers who are wearing their tough guy shirts with their kids. I went to the pet store today, and I was watching dads walking around, looking at other men with their eyes. I'm powerful. You know how powerful I am. I'm like, are you powerful enough to know what's going on in your food and water? Are you powerful enough to admit there's big, evil people above you, and that you're not just strutting around here in the fish section of the place acting tough? Okay, pal? I see these Arrested Development men. It just makes me want to throw up. And their eyes are so weak. I wish they would face reality. I wish they'd become real men. I mean, how can a man hear this stuff? How can listeners hear what I've said today, new listeners, and not go check out everything I've said? If there was one chance in a million it was true, you'd look it up. Unfortunately, it's all true and worse than I can even tell you. Oh, we got Jason, Carl, John, Ken, John, Chris, Jeff, Wyatt, Teeny. Let's go to Teeny with a name like that. Teeny in Indiana, where the ATF ships guns to drug gangs to kill their opposition. That came out in federal court. How are you doing up there?
Oh, I'm doing fine. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm just wonderful.
You look good. I'm watching you.
Well, thank you, ma'am. It's always nice to have a woman tell me I look good. I appreciate that.
You do. You always have nice clothes on.
Well, thank you.
Anyways, I wanted to tell you, I've got a new thing for the prostitutes. It's educated, stupid prostitutes. Educated because they went to school. Stupid because they're too stupid to leave their pimps.
That's a good name, but I mean, I think I'm going to steal Rand Paul, Wayne Paul, brother Ron Paul's term, the sewer line media or the sewer stream media, because we already think of them as mainstream. No, they're the sewer stream. I appreciate your information there. Good to hear from you. Let's go ahead and talk to Jason in Texas. Jason, you're on the air.
How are you going today?
I appreciate you putting up with me, brother. I'm doing good.
Alrighty, I got one little data point. Just recently, I watched the new Planet of the Apes movie, The Rise of the Apes.
Yeah, it's about a bioweapon, yeah.
Yeah, and they had some sort of mistake there at the biolab, and one of the attendants.
And everybody dies. After the credits, it shows the map of all of everyone on Earth dying. Isn't
right.
it beautiful?
Well, you can kind of see the thinly veiled propaganda where, like, the apes are safe, and... So then they come out from the destructed civilization, and they become the new rulers of the world.
And if you notice, you're right. In the background, the astronauts have launched. That's 2001 Space Odyssey. They're going to come back. Yeah, that gets into Illuminati stuff. That's pretty deep there. God bless you. Sorry to all the other callers. Love you. Back tomorrow, God willing, 11 a.m. Central. Great job to the crew, PrisonPlanet.tv.
We've got it. The transmission is coming to you.
Waging war on corruption.
All right, you want to go?
It's Alex Jones coming to you live from the front lines of the info war.
We've got it.
I was sitting there this morning and this afternoon with a little notebook, and I'd written about 10 pages of text of issues that I wanted to cover here today, not so much from a futurist perspective. That's kind of what the popular lexicon would label it as, in an attempt to simplify things. You know, the future is here. It's been here for a long time. There are technological, government, and corporate reservations that are highly advanced above the quasi-dormant